Greetings. Welcome to Talk About Pop Music. This is the Vinyl View segment. This week I will be discussing
Rush. Rush Through Time.
Rush Through Time is a compilation album that was released initially in 1979 in Germany as a picture disc, and subsequently in the Netherlands and other markets in 1982 with a regular basic sleeve. It's a compilation album that features selections from the band's second, third, fourth, and fifth albums, which are Fly By Night, Caress of Steel, 2112, and Farewell to Kings. The biggest hits here are Closer to the Heart and Fly By Night. It was released without the band's consent or permission, but it is a legitimate release nonetheless. It's a nice little compilation album. It serves virtually no purpose other than being a sampler for the German, Netherlands, and Mexican markets. I am not a Rush fan. I've never really been a huge fan of them, other than their singles. So that doesn't really make me a fan at all. I've never been able to get past Geddy Lee's voice, or Neil Peart's inclination to overplay, dare I say. Now, if you are a Rush fan, this is something that you don't need, but if you are a vinyl fanatic, I would advise you pick up for as little money as possible. If you can see, the price here is $1, which I picked up at St. Mark's Sounds in the mid-1990s, and I gifted it to a friend of mine. Actually, I gifted it to Dave Rauchich of TV Games fame. Vinyl's nice. It's nice. It looks like Dave really didn't play it all that much, because he didn't really need to, because he is a Rush fan and has all their albums. But this is nice. I mean, it's beautiful vinyl that's sort of a molded label. Yeah, it's very, you know, German records and European records, whether from Germany or the United Kingdom, I've always been a fan of. They don't go for million-dollar pressings as far as, you know, spend as little amount of money as possible because you're going to be selling 50 million copies of these. This was obviously not the goal with this record. It was just to make some money, or as much money as possible on something that Mercury Records owned, which was the Rush catalog at the time. Rush Through Time. It's a silly pun, and I guess that's probably the indicator right there that they probably had nothing to do with it, because they're probably not going to make puns of their name. Okay, talk about pop music. I'm Bill Wickstrom, and this was the Vinyl Views segments.